Well, Mr. Trump's feud with sanctuary cities puts a lot of places in the White House's crosshairs.
But what about Los Angeles? CBS 2's Randy Page spoke with the mayor and the sheriff to get some answers.
In Washington this week, after President Donald Trump signed an executive order calling for a crackdown on so-called sanctuary cities, White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer explained what this could mean to cities and counties that don't comply.
We're going to strip federal grant money from the sanctuary states and cities that harbor illegal immigrants.
The Trump administration wants local law enforcement agencies to delay the release of undocumented immigrants until federal immigration agents have a chance to pick them up. But that's not how it's done at the LA County Jail.
Nothing will change from our standpoint.
Sheriff Jim McDonald says when people are taken into custody, their identity is instantly available by computer to immigration agents. The sheriff says people are released from jail when the state criminal justice system says it's time for them to go. If federal agents want to show up at the time of the inmate's release, they can take that person into custody.
And they go through who's got about to be released, and then they do what it is they do to be able to deal with their issues.
But LA County will not hold inmates beyond their release date to make it easier for federal agents to pick them up. Sheriff McDonald says it's critical for members of the immigrant community to trust his deputies and cooperate with criminal investigations.
So what happens if Donald Trump withholds those federal funds earmarked for local law enforcement? We put that question to Eric Garcetti.
So I don't think we'll be in that situation, but worst case scenario, even if they threaten those funds, we can't change what makes our people safe. Public safety is not negotiable for me. The safety of the people that I'm charged with protecting comes first, even over federal funding.
The city is exploring its legal options while at the same time trying to avoid a showdown with the new president. In downtown Los Angeles, Randy Page, CBS 2 News.